Hello everyone, my name is Denzel Rodriguez, your personal finance geek, and today we're going to talk about it. Residual income. How do I make it happen? How do I get me some residual income, man? I'm trying to do velocity banking. I'm trying to pay off all my debt. I'm trying to get financial freedom in my life. I want to create the lifestyle for myself, my family, my friends, people that I love. And if I'm going to do those things, I need to learn how to create some residual income. Am I right? What I was thinking about doing is like documenting my whole process on how I'm gonna create residual income for myself and just share it with you guys along the way. And if you're really smart and you wanna jump on this journey with me together, I can, the saying is called sprinkle the infield. Okay, so I can sprinkle the wealth. Whatever I learn, you learn. I grow, you grow. The whole idea is that you have to invest in yourself first so that you can learn how to invest in others, so that you can know, like, and trust people when it comes to financial knowledge, wisdom, information, things like that. And let's see where we go. I want to give you guys kind of like a recap of how we've been growing so far, right? If you're new to this channel, welcome. My name's Denzel. All I do on this channel is talk about velocity banking, infinite banking, and kingdom authority. I share my experiences. I share my clients' experiences on how they are paying off debt by simply illustrating number by number, line by line, how we, you know, maximize cash flow, pay off debt, build credit score, all using our own income, right? By leveraging the bank's money in the form of HELOCs, personal line of credit, or credit cards. All right. And this is both on the personal side and the business. So let's go back day one when I first started recording videos and up until this point right now. When I first launched the YouTube channel, I was putting out one video every single day for about 3 to 6 months at least. I'm sure you guys remember this. Before I started, I got fired at my job. I was in debt well over $25,000. No income. Didn't know what to do. And from a simple suggestion from a friend telling me that I should record videos because I had a good voice. That was it. I like took that and said, you know what? This is all I got. I have no desire to look for another job. I know this is what I wanted to do. I just didn't know how to do it, right? I knew I wanted to be in finances. I knew there was this gift I had. I knew I wanted to talk about velocity banking and help clients. I knew that was my thing, just didn't know how to do it. So 2018, end of, what was it? Like, I think my first video I published was like in August. I think August or like maybe July. Yeah, July or August was like my first video I dropped. I got 26 views like the first day. I was like ecstatic. I was jumping off my seat. I haven't made a dollar yet, but I was excited because 26 freaking people just watched my video like all the way through. And I had like 10 comments like within like, I think the first couple of days, like people were actually responding, liking the video, and I really never looked back from there. So the first part was recording content. I think recording content is so key if I'm going to build residual income for my life. We have to separate residual income from activity income. Okay, so the actual making content, that's the activity. Right? Residual income is once you've done the activity and now you get paid for it forever and ever and ever. So that means I could stop making content, but that doesn't mean the income would stop. That doesn't mean the money would stop. Okay, so that's how we separate activity income from residual. So I will say this, when I first started making my YouTube videos, putting them on the internet, sharing it with the world, sharing my ideas, all of that was activity, 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 income coming in, right? I was coaching, I was consulting, I was helping people were paying me, one-time service for, a service for me to teach them velocity banking, kingdom authority, or the infinite banking concept, or, working with me to build their policy out. I've been doing that for over a year now, and I've been able to bring in a little over 200,000 in revenue up to date. Now, the key part is keeping that momentum going, right? So you would think the hard part is actually making the money. That's, I think, most people struggle right there, is making the money. And for me, I would agree. It was definitely hard. Like the first 3 to 6 months was difficult. Like my first month, I made under $500, and then every month it went up a little bit more and more until like I hit like a breakthrough point, which was like I had like a 6K month. And really, that was mainly due to my principles behind Kingdom, right? My whole principles and fundamentals behind my Kingdom authority, giving, tithing, always putting other people, like I should say, give first, right? You're like, but without the expectation of something in return. So I'm giving out of my heart. I'm not, giving to get. It's not how that system works. I would say another fundamental principle tool that I took advantage of was the whole concept of consistency. We have to be super consistent if we're going to create residual income. Okay, so analyzing, if you're going to analyze my channel and I'm going to start documenting my experience, I think this is very important. I think it's going to help a lot of people in terms of where you go. In terms of how you build your financial life outside of velocity banking, right? These are the fundamental lines, but we want to be able to create things in our lives so that we don't have to worry about activity forever. Because you can't work forever, right? No matter who you are, you cannot work forever. So we have to create these streams of income that no matter what, it'll come in, right? So now that I've been recording content for over a year, done a little over 200K in revenue, cash flow is good, my credit's good, I have no debt. Now what I'm focusing on is creating residual income. For me, I believe the best route to go, whether I was just starting out, in the middle, or up until this point right now, is to really start looking at network marketing, MLM, direct sales. One of the three. This is a major, major industry. Okay. And then the other one being real estate, of course, which is in my plan already. I think the main reason why I want to really dive into network marketing is that ability to have community, networks, relationship, the ability to have multiple people grow with me at the same time. Whereas if I was to just invest in real estate and do real estate investing, that's going to be solely on the individual for them to acquire the information and acquire the knowledge. So for me, I'm learning how to invest in real estate. I'm forging relationships with people. So that work is solely on me to perform. Whereas when you look at the network marketing space, you're able to leverage other people's time. You're able to leverage other people's networks, right? And all you have to put your 100% effort into it. You have to bring yourself to the table, right? To be presentable and for someone to, trust in you and believe in you. But it's like once you forge that, it's amazing what can occur. So what I've been building on the low, right? Because my main thing will always be velocity banking, infinite banking, and kingdom authority. I'm not changing that. That's my purpose. That's my calling in life. That's my career right there. That's my job. That's my business. It's what I love to talk about. That's not going away no time soon. Okay. What I want to be able to do now is work with people like you. I want to work with people who have similar drive, just like me. You want something more in life, not just for yourself, but for the people around you. You want to help people. You want to evangelize. I mean, you just want to just really put yourself out there and be of service, right? And have the authority to command, right? And have dominion over your life, over your household, right? And just really have the authority to just guide people, right? And lead them, okay? So on the low, I've been building a Legal Shield business and Carrot Bars. I've been looking at these two companies. I've been a customer for like the longest. And now I'm like, how do I integrate this stuff into my business so that I can provide opportunities for other people that also want to make money in the process of paying off all their debt, doing velocity banking, building up their life insurance policy, building up their household, starting up a business, whatever it is. So, in the links below, I have two opportunities that you can check out, Legal Shield and Carrot Bars being one of them. Listen, I don't understand how the compensation stuff works. I don't know how to make money in network marketing. Don't ask me those questions. All I know is that the opportunity is there, and the consistency of promoting something. So if you look at my channel and you see, okay, over the last year, all he did was talk about the same thing over and over again and just said it 1,000 different ways. Well, if all I did was do that again, right, and integrate it with everything, with what I do, then I should be successful. So that's what I've been doing, and I've been able to generate about $50 to $100 in residual income through Legal Shield, which is not bad at all, right? Now, this is not monthly, just so far, just by making videos and just sharing the links in the description below, having it on my website, talking about it from time to time. I've made videos in the past, but now I'm gonna up my game a little bit in terms of my content output and really focusing on residual income. Because it's so important. There's gonna be many opportunities that are gonna start coming my way, and I need to make myself available. So I can't be tied up in the activity if I wanna keep growing. So if I wanna go from 200K a month to 400K, if I wanna go from 200K in a year to 400K, right? Or if I wanna go from making, 15 to 20,000 a month to 30 to 45K a month, I really need to get my residual game popping. So, this is ground level where I'm at in terms of Legal Shield and Carrot Bars. If you are interested in starting a home-based business, I'm going to start creating content around the tools needed to create that home-based business, what you're going to need in terms of creating content, building a brand. I'm no expert in these things. I'm just simply going to share what I've been doing over the past year because obviously it's worked and I have all the data to show it right to you so that we can build trust up front. And when you're ready, we can join in Legal Shield together or Carrot Bars and let's just start sharing amazing products and services with the world to people. Just like I do already with Velocity Banking and Infinite Banking, all I'm going to be doing is adding to my arsenal, just adding more tools to my belt. All right. My name is Denzel. Hope this video was helpful. Nice starter, right? I want to just crack open this case right here and let's see where we go from here. All right. Have a wonderful day. God bless.